I'm Richard Wigglesworth.
Richard, it's fantastic to have you here tonight. What makes tonight such a very special, important night, supporting this charity and celebrating Charlie next to you?
Well, I think it's a big event on the rugby calendar now, us getting together for this Nordoff Robbins dinner. Every year it blows you away with all the help they give all these people, and brilliant to be part of it, and extra special that it's one of my very good friends, Charlie Hodgson's testimonial due, and celebrating his fantastic career, and it'll be a great night all round.
Of course, excitement for the Six Nations starting to reach fever pitch now. What makes the Six Nations unique as a sporting experience, and what are you most excited for this season?
I think like anything, it's got important. It's got a massive amount of tradition, all that history that goes with it. So many great games and championships down the year. I think England are the team to beat again. They look really strong. Obviously had a couple of injuries recently, but strength in depth is there, and I'm backing them to win it again.
And what do you think about the work that Eddie Jones has done since coming on board? Because I think the fans have been, I think, delighted to see that consistency finally there.
Well, I think consistency is the word. He's lost one game in 2.5 years, something that's a pretty impressive record. So he's obviously brought a huge amount to it. The lads have bought into what he's doing, and the simple things England do really, really well. Got a great set piece and great defence, and they're improving all the time. All the signs are there.
Of course, every time we have the Six Nations, it inevitably leads to a discussion about that North-Southern Hemisphere divide. Where do you think we are on that spectrum at the moment? Because I think there's a real sense that after last year, England were really at a point where there really wasn't much to choose between North and South.
Well, I don't think there is a divide. I think that's gone. I think we had to take it on the chin that there was last World Cup, but there's no divide now. I think New Zealand are the number one team in the world, but England are number two, so and Ireland are a top, top team. So I don't see any divide.
Of course, looking forward to the championship, people are excited about the teams, but we're also excited about individual players. Are there any individuals in particular that you think are really primed to have a big championship at the Six Nations?
I'm always biased towards the Saracens players, but Owen Farrell's incredibly important to what England do, as is Maro Itoje. I think Maro's had a little four-week break with a broken jaw and looks ready to explode, so I think those two fellas will have a big championship.